And because of this bacterial change that happened with time-restricted fasting and intermittent eating or energy-restricted fasting, because of these two types of fasts, what they started to see, the changes in the microbiome led to the changes in leaky gut, that inner mucosal lining healed. Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I am back with new science, specifically talking about how fasting can help heal a leaky gut. So if you're new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. I'm a woman on a mission. I am dedicated to getting 1 million people here to my channel this year. I see so much evidence on how fasting is going to end chronic disease. Studies like this prove it over and over and over again. So welcome if you're new, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell and dive into the studies I've done, the application of fasting that I've done here and all the tools, hopefully, that you will find here for building a fasting lifestyle. And those of you that send my videos out, again, I adore you and I just love being on this journey with you. We will change chronic disease with fasting. Okay. This study is super cool. So I want to kind of give you a big picture. We know from past studies, one of the most famous studies on fasting was done on the 24-hour fast. It was a mouse study, and it proved that at 24 hours, you would get intestinal stem cells that would be produced. Stem cells are very powerful because what they do is they go in and they start to heal any injured areas. So in that study, they started to see that you could actually change the mucosal lining, the inner lining of a gut that was causing a leaky gut situation. Now, I'm going to talk about what leaky gut is here in a moment. We've had that study for several years now. It was out of MIT. I talk about it a lot. This study came out in April 2020, so it's a little over a year old. And it was specifically looking at leaky gut. So let's talk about what leaky gut is. On the inside of your gut, you have a mucosal lining, a protective lining that should be very tight, like saran wrap. And it protects toxins from getting into the bloodstream and going straight up to your brain. It also protects undigested food from getting in your bloodstream and going up into other parts of the body and creating an inflammatory response. So leaky gut is a really challenging situation because what happens is these tight junctions, this saran wrap on the inside of your gut, what ends up happening is you start to get openings. This is the leaky part. And that undigested food can get in, toxins can get in, and they can create an inflammatory response. Here's the challenge. They don't always create an inflammatory response in your gut. They often create the inflammatory response in your brain. I have an incredible podcast that I just interviewed Dr. Stephen Gundry on. It's called the podcast we talked about, his new book called The Energy Paradox. And when I asked him why so many people had energy problems, he said the number one reason, literally the number one reason, was because of a leaky gut. And you can go listen to that. Go to the Resetter podcast on iTunes. You can go listen to him describe this. And he said it's because when these junctions open up, what happens is this undigested food and toxins get in and it causes the brain to swell. And when the brain swells, you don't have brain clarity, you don't have energy, your body starts to tank. So what studies like this one that I'm gonna explain to you are showing to us is that we can undo that, and we can undo it very quickly through fasting. So know that leaky gut is potentially not a gut issue for you. You may have leaky gut and not have a gut symptom. You may have a brain symptom. Now, the other thing before I dive into the study, I just want to point out to you is that there are 4 major causes of a leaky gut. Allergies to food. So foods like gluten and anything wheat-oriented tends to cause a leaky gut. Second is glyphosate. Any non-organic, genetically modified, sprayed food is going to create a leaky gut. Antibiotics. So any round of antibiotics you've ever been on will open these junctions up. And then stress. So the more chronic stress you're under, the more these junctions will open. So that's pretty much all of us. You can't be a human on this planet and get away from antibiotics and glyphosate and stress at this particular moment. So most of us have some type of leaky gut. Okay, let's dive into the study. They looked at three types of fasting: alternate day fasting, time restricted eating, which is really interesting, and intermittent energy restriction. And I'm gonna talk, that's a new one. I'm gonna talk about this. And what they found is that alternate day fasting was not as effective as time restricted eating, which is like autophagy fasting where you're going 17 hours, and intermittent energy restriction fasting, which is where you're keeping your calories under 500 grams. Little more like fast mimicking diet. And what they found was after doing this style, the intermittent energy restriction fasting and the time restricted eating, what they found was that there were massive changes in the microbiome. And two of those changes are profound. The bad bacteria came down. Specifically, they looked at E. coli and they looked at Shigella. Those two bacteria came down. Those bacteria died off. The second thing that they noticed is the anti-inflammatory bacteria, the one that's gonna bring the neuroinflammation down, increased. So bad bacteria down, good bacteria up. And because of this bacterial change that happened with time-restricted fasting and intermittent eating or energy-restricted fasting, because of these two types of fasts, what they started to see, the changes in the microbiome led to the changes in leaky gut, that intermucosal lining healed. So this is really encouraging because we know if we're gonna do more time-restricted fasting, more of the 15 hour, more of the 17 hours, the 36, 48, everything I'm teaching you here, that we're healing leaky gut, bringing inflammation down, changing the microbiome. We also know that more of this intermittent energy restriction, which is keeping your calories under 500 to 600 calories a day, also heals the leaky gut. What's really interesting about the intermittent energy restriction diet or style of fasting is that they only do it 3 days out of the week. So 4 days they ate whatever they want, 3 days they keep their calories under 500 to 600 calories a day. So those of you that don't wanna fast all the time, this is great news. You can still heal your gut by keeping calories low for at least 3 days out of your week, and the rest of the week you can eat whatever you want. You know, that's up to you what style that you eat, but you're still gonna get some gut repair. So all the research coming out right now, you guys, on intermittent fasting, on the longer fast, so much of it is about the microbiome change. And here is another example of how we can make a change without a supplement. Intermittent energy restriction is even showing us that we can make a change without fasting every single day. So as always, let me know if that helps. If you guys are wanting to dive into understanding your gut better, you want to know more about leaky gut syndrome, you can get a gut zoomer. We do stool tests and consultations with those tests all the time. Just go to Dr. Mindy Pell's and we have links to those tests, or you can just put gut zoomer in the comments and my team will send you a link. So that's an option for you. The second option for you to learn more about this, go listen to the podcast I did with Dr. Gundry. Fascinating. Top two reasons for leaky gut. He talks about it in there. One is antibiotics. Two is glyphosate. Again, things that we are exposed to that on a daily basis. And if you really want to dive into fixing your gut with fasting, I have a great video that I talk about that MIT study called Can You Fix Your Gut with Fasting? So those are some great resources for you. But we've got to bring the inflammation down, and tools and studies like this are proving that we can. If you have changed your gut health through fasting, put it in the comments so that the community can learn. And as always, I hope that helps.